Happy, blessed, glorious, wonderful Mother's Day.
Amen.
For
Amen.
All the mothers all over the world, we want to wish you. You know, you mothers, you are such a special thing. Such a special thing.
Thing.
Commodity. You are such a specialty. You know, many times mothers feel, what am I? I'm just at home. I'm just working. Nobody sees me. Nobody appreciates me. The children scold me. Nobody really takes care of me. Many times mothers can feel like that. But you know how important you are. If you had not taken this decision of, okay, I will have this child, how much we would miss. I was thinking this morning about Mary. You know, we say, Mother Mary, Hail Mother Mary. Many people will say like that. Actually, she does deserve a very high honor. You know why Mary, this Mother Mary, why she deserves such a high honor? Because her life was in danger. When she took this decision, okay, let it be to me according to your word. She took the decision to take the word of God brought to her through an angel, to take it so serious that she could make her life stand on it. Okay, if God gives me such a word, if I die, I die. But if God really needs this child, He will take care of me, that I can survive, that I can bring forth this child. What a woman. You know, there are many women like this all over the world, especially when a woman becomes pregnant in a difficult situation. When she has this very easy option, okay, delete it, okay, erase it, okay, do an abortion. When she has this easy option nowadays all over the world, but she decides to go through with the pregnancy, she decides to keep this child, she should be highly honored, highly esteemed, because
yes,
this mother is one of the foundations of society. Children many times don't understand how much it costs a mother to have a child, to raise a child. How much it hurts a mother, how many difficulties they go through, how much they carry the child, how many mothers don't eat so that they can feed the child, how many mothers eat the leftovers and give all the best things to the child, how many mothers?
No, my mother have 9 children.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Suddenly my daddy will bring visitors. Guess. And my mother had to give all the food and she will go without food.
Yeah.
So I will watch it.
Yeah.
I will watch it. It hurts me very much. Suddenly, you know, daddy, men, they don't realize.
Yeah.
They bring the people for visitors, guests, and whatever we have, only I know, my mother know, the food is not there. But she will give. Many nights she went without food.
Mm.
Mothers are really sacrificial.
Sacrificial.
People. God remembers that.
God remembers
that.
Sees
that.
Yes. See, our mommy, she's above 90 now. With this sacrificial lifestyle, God is keeping her alive. God still uses her to bless so many people. So a mother must be loved. A mother must be appreciated. A mother must be honored. A mother should be proud because she accepted that life from God. The devil cannot create life. The devil came to steal, kill, and destroy. So if you have this temptation, why not I get rid of this child while it's in the womb? Why not I get rid of this child now that it's born, give it to somebody else? If you have this temptation, I can tell you the temptation does not come from God because your God is a God of life. We just had a case here. There was a miscarriage and very quickly a pregnancy came and everybody says, are you now? How can you become pregnant? No, you have to wait a long time. You have to wait. Oh, your body has to recover. But we said, if God gives life, God will take care of it. Yesterday, we got a very nice report. Praise God. God is the one who gives life. Please, please receive it. Please, please accept it. The devil is fighting against life all over the world. One Mary. Imagine this one Mary would not have accepted the gift of life in such a special way. No? By angel prophesied, by the Holy Spirit put into her special life. But she had to accept it. She could have said no. We would not have salvation. We would not have a Jesus. Your child that you have, mother, it's a special child. It's a precious child. It's a child planned by God. It's a seed that God has planned. God has created. Never think, this useless child. No. You get God's vision for this child. You start speaking God's plan over this child. This child today maybe does not receive you. There is a time, you know, in the teenage, there is a time that's very, very painful for mothers, especially when the children become teenagers. Very, very difficult. But you know, even this time is a God-made time, because it's the time where the young person finds out, who am I? Up to now, I accepted everything from my parents. Now I have to find out who am I? What will be my lifestyle? So in that time, they will question everything. They will rebel against everything you do. Don't take it serious. It's just a time. Don't allow the devil to hurt you. It's just a time. This child will come to the realization, what a precious gift God has given with this mother, with you, mother. So today we just want to honor you. We just want to bless you. We are so much talking recently about Deborah, prophetess Deborah. Bible says such a strong word. Bible says the village life ceased.
Stopped. They ceased in Israel.
In whole Israel. The life in the villages totally stopped, collapsed, everything stopped. Until I arose, Deborah, a mother in Israel. Mothers are such important, important, precious things from God. Precious people.
Yes.
Each and every mother. Don't allow the devil to pull you down. Just my hubby told how his own mother wanted to commit suicide. I didn't know that. What a shocking thing. The devil might be speaking to you. Please, mother, you know, you are a precious jewel in the hands of God. God has chosen you to bring forth a new generation. You can raise this generation with your prayers. Cover it, protect it. The children that God has given you. But never pray only for your child. You think about, oh, the situation my child is in. Many other children will have the same situation. So broaden your prayer. Don't pray only for that one child. Pray for all the children.
Be
pray
a spiritual
for all
mother.
The people.
Be a spiritual mother. Yeah. For yeah. a multitude.
As in the beginning for your, in your prayer, as you pray for many people, as you pray for the whole school, not only for your child, for the whole school, for the whole university, wherever the children are, God will give you more and more and more spiritual children. We just bless you. We respect you. We honor you. We love you. Bless you.
We pray for you. Mm-hmm. You are a mother
yeah.
for the nations.
Yeah.
Nations are waiting.
Amen.
There are people, as people are waiting for father, mothers. There are so many orphans. Mm. And even spiritual people, they look for mothers
yeah.
and fathers.
Yeah.
This is your time.
Yeah.
Not only your children.
Yeah.
Rise up like a mother, Deborah.
Yeah.
And raise up Barak.
Yeah.
We are here to pray for you
yeah.
and bless you.
Yeah.
God remembers you. Shall we pray now?
Yes.
Father, me and my wife agree, as spiritual parents, that you have raised us. We bless all the mothers
yes,
who hears these words.
Yes,
we release your blessings over them. Lord, let them rise up like Mother Deborah. Let them
yeah.
care about the nations also. Let all their life not be wasted, only focusing on their children, their husbands, their families. Enlarge them, Lord. Enlarge their vision. As they take care of spiritual orphans, as they rise up like spiritual mother, you will take care of their kids, Lord. And you will bring them and you will make them mighty witnesses for your glory. So me and my wife, we bless the mothers of this nation. Lord, whatever is torturing them, whatever is hurting them, listen, watch them, Lord, and let it bring such a joy.
Yes,
we bless you in Jesus' name.
Yes, Father, in the name of Jesus, right now, Lord, in this time, special time, where so many families cannot be together, maybe many mothers might be lonely, might be sitting even in a senior citizen's home somewhere, lonely, not allowed to receive visit, not allowed to see the children. Father, let them just feel your smile. So many mothers working so hard and the children don't appreciate it. They just mock and reject and whatever, just make fun of the mothers and just really despise their mother. Father, let your smile be so strong upon them. I'm asking you for this Mother's Day, Lord. Let the mothers feel the pleasure of God. the smile of God upon their lives for the sacrifice that they are bringing for the nation, for their children, for the new generation. Father, let them feel your touch. Let the touch of God, presence of the Holy Ghost right now, comfort every mother, strengthen every mother, bless every mother, heal every mother, heal the deep inner hurts that have been always definitely created in every family setup. Hurts are created. So Holy Spirit, you take care of that also. Let this be a day of healing. Let it be a day of restoration. Lord, maybe they can talk only on the phone, but let them be so blessed. Make it a special day all over the world for all the mothers of the nations.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, we bless them. Father, every pregnancy where the doctors say difficult pregnancy, you take control.
Yes,
you
Lord.
Take control. You're the God of life. Let the miracle happen right now. Let this child in the womb again start moving. Let this life in the womb rise up again.
Yes,
Lord, I rebuke every devil's attack trying to kill babies even inside the womb. No, devil, you will not do it. We bless the mothers. Healthy, happy pregnancy. Healthy, happy birth. And very nice family life. A miracle in Jesus' name.
Father, raise up the children to understand the sacrifice the mothers have made for them. And let them become thankful, Lord. Let this Mother's Day be a new beginning for every mother who hears us, Lord. Let this year, let the children bring joy and call them blessed moms.
Amen. Yes.
And also let the husbands recognize the cost the mother pays for the kids and let them appreciate in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name, yes. Amen. Father, we decree a miracle Mother's Day in this special year. Miracle Mother's Day in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.